Hello, good morning guys. Today I am going to be talking about mental health, as you can see on my whiteboard, and I am going to be telling you 7 things that I do for my own mental health. They can be different for you, they can be same for you, similar for you, but I think that if I tell you about my things that I do for mental health, then maybe they will be useful for you. And before you start the video, please switch on the subtitles so it will be easier for you to follow the video. Let's get started. First thing that I do to maintain or improve my mental health is listen to a lot of music. Then I listen to guided meditations on YouTube, and I also listen to audiobooks on an app called Libby. So let me tell you about some music. So I do like to listen to like a little bit up tempo music or something really nice and energizing. Like I've been like into these two bands called Pomplamoose and Scary Pockets. They are cover bands and they do like funk covers and stuff. Like they are amazing. So they just like create this energy in their music, and it just improves my vibrations. I can feel my energy getting up. Also, I listen to guided meditations by these two channels mainly. First channel is called The Honest Guys, and the second channel is called by a person called Michael Steely, and their guided meditations are amazing. One favorite is called Mindfulness Meditation, and it's a 10-minute meditation, and it just grounds me, and like that meditation just, it's amazing. Like it can transform like or transport me from some like world of worries and some negative energy filled world to like a positive, present, mindful world, and it's amazing. The third thing I listen to often is audiobooks, and they are amazing. I like to go for walks while listening to audiobooks, but unfortunately now we are in lockdown, so we can't. But still, it's amazing. I can just go and sit on the terrace and listen to an audiobook. So the second thing I do is create music or play with music or sing or play piano. I have keyboards, and they I don't know anything, like I don't know how to play, but I really enjoy playing them and singing along. And I just look up a tutorial online and try to follow how to play a song on piano, and I can maybe follow like 5 to 10% of it, but still it's amazing. I can spend hours and hours doing that.
So manic talking, we know you will have to try. You're cute enough to fuck with me tonight. Looking at the table, all I see is weird and white. Baby, you're living a life, but you ain't living right.
It instantly boosts my mood, and it's amazing. Like, I can feel my vibrations like getting higher and higher at a higher frequency, and I feel like it's amazing for my mental health. So if you are somebody who likes to play some instrument or listen to music or sing music, karaoke is amazing. It just uplifts you. The next thing I do is self-care or self-love acts, like taking a shower before bed, maybe putting on a face mask. And I don't really like to buy skincare products or anything like that, because I don't know what chemicals there are in them and if they are plant-based or not. I want to use as natural as things on my skin as possible. So I have this aloe vera plant, and it's amazing. I'm so grateful for it. I take a little bit of flesh from aloe vera and like put it on my face or on my hair, and it's amazingly nourishing and moisturizing. And I also eat some nice fruits or drink coffee like I'm drinking right now. It's amazing. Like, these kind of self-care acts go a long way to uplift your mental health and your mood. So I recommend them very much. The next thing that calms me down and makes my mental health better are books. This is the book. It's amazing. This is what I'm reading every day, every night, I have integrated reading one chapter of this before bed in my nighttime routine. And I am so grateful. I get some very timely lessons from this. It's about spirituality and mental health and ego and how to be conscious and live consciously. Other than that, I also love to read fiction and books that like educate and amazing. Like, I love books. I really am looking forward to reading this one also by Zadie Smith, and I just love books and they just uplift my mental health a lot. And especially now I've started reading these kind of books, they're a little difficult to understand, but I really, really like them, and I'm just digesting them a little bit at a time, but amazing, I love it. The next thing I want to talk to you about is writing. It has helped me so much. In 2021, I have been keeping a journal, and writing in my journal before bed, it has become a routine now, and it's just amazing. It immediately switches me from the hectic day to gratitude, like the mindset of gratitude. I write about 5 things that I'm grateful for that day in the journal before sleeping. That just like helps me a lot to focus on things that are important and that I'm grateful for. And I also write about random stuff, also write about things that I want to do in future or the next day or anything, all my thoughts, negative, positive, and there is an outlet to that, and writing, it helps me amazingly, tremendously. So I do recommend keeping a journal. Just like 1 page per day is just amazingly helpful, so I do recommend this. The next thing, the 6th thing, I think I'm keeping track of it, right? 6th thing is very, very important, is going to therapy. So I have started going to a therapist recently, and it has helped me uplift my mental health a lot. So it's not always affordable. It's not the most natural thing for somebody to do. Maybe it is natural for in some cultures, but in Indian culture, it's not very something that everybody does very comfortably, but I do recommend it, and I got recommended one by a friend. So if you need any recommendations or anything to talk about going to therapy, please let me know. It's amazingly helpful, and I feel like I am like improved, like I have improved in 1 or 2 months that I have been going to therapy. In my state of my mental health and has improved, and I just think it is amazing. Going to therapist can benefit pretty much everybody, anybody, and anybody can use therapy, I think. And the 7th thing, last but not the least, is taking a break. Taking a break for a mindfulness break, or to ground yourself in the moment. So for that, I really think it's different for everybody. For me, I think I like drinking coffee in the morning to ground myself, and it's amazing and it wakes you up, bonus. And also love green tea. So I did a course where I learned Japanese tea ceremony, and there is a philosophy behind Japanese tea ceremony, which is enjoying simplicity, also enjoying the moment. There is a word, or there is a phrase called ichigo ichie in Japanese, which means one moment only once. So you get to have one moment only once. So the person who makes tea for the guests, or the person in the tea ceremony, tries to make it the best moment, as best as possible for the guest. So I really love it, and I really like the philosophy behind it. And drinking green tea is amazing. I love the taste also, and how it makes me feel. So I take a break now and then and drink some green tea, make some green tea and drink some matcha green tea. And even if you don't like tea, you like coffee or you like juice or whatever you want to drink, take a break, ground yourself, savor the moment, and maybe after that you will feel instantly better in terms of mental health. So please try these things. And if you have any other things that you do to improve your mental health, please let them leave them in the comments, or like let me know. I don't know how to do this, but I would love to listen to things that you do. For example, I could be doing more exercise. I could be doing more volunteer work. That is amazing for your mental health. Exercise, like, it's obviously no need to explain, but it just improves your physical and mental health a lot. And helping others is amazing. Like, if sometimes you don't know how to help yourself, help other people and you will get help, like, in the process. It's like amazing. So I'm going to try and incorporate those two things more in my self love and self care and mental health improvement routine. So let me know what you guys want to do or you already do to maintain good health, mental and physical. And I hope you are doing well, and I hope this video will be helpful to you in some way. And I send you really good vibrations, and I feel like you will definitely have amazing time today, at least after you watch the video. Please put yourself in that mindset of having a great time, and even if it is uncomfortable right now, you are going through a tough time, I think if you tried a couple of things to uplift your mood and better your mental health, I think it will help you. So yeah, that's it for me, and I will see you in the next video.